The very first thing that Pastor wants to say to you today is that, number one, the devil is a liar, and number two, you're getting this right. As a child of God, you are getting this right. I believe everything today that you are facing and I am facing as a born-again believer, I believe as the bride of Christ, as a man of God, as a woman of God, that is part and partial to the kingdom of God, His bride, His church. Everything you face in the midst of the stuff that's going on right now, I believe it is connected to spiritual warfare. And today, I just wanted to tell you, as that man and as that woman of God, you're getting it right. Paul said these words in Ephesians chapter number 6, verses 10 through 12. He said, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles or the strategy of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, and against spiritual wickedness in high places." Please remember, you're stronger in the Lord than the devil is trying to convince you that you are. As a man of God again, as a woman of God, you got this. You really got it. And I just want to speak into your spirit today, and those of you that are doing the very best that you possibly can to honor God, you're living the right example, you're being faithful to the Word of God, and you're worshiping before Him, honoring His sanctuary, I just come to tell you, you're getting it right. You really, really have got it right. Philippians chapter 4 and verse number 13 says that you and I, as born-again believers, can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth us. And even if the enemy does come in like a flood, remember, you and God have this. You have it. As a matter of fact, the prophet Isaiah prophesied about you and God in Isaiah chapter 59 and verse number 19. He said, "So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and His glory from the rising of the sun, when the enemy shall come in like a flood." It's right then and there that the Spirit of the Lord through you will lift up a standard against him. As a child of God, the Spirit of God that lives inside of you is lifting up the standard of the Lord against the enemy on your behalf. You're getting it right. I know you can look at a lot of places and see a lot of things that's going on and a lot of things are being said. But today, I just wanted to tell you, you're really getting it right as a child of God. It's not all everything that the enemy is trying to show you or even trying to convince you of. I want you to listen to what Jesus said in 2 Corinthians chapter number 12, verses 9 and 10. This is what Jesus is saying unto you. He's saying, "My grace is sufficient for thee." Because he said, "For strength is made perfect in weakness." When you feel like you're just not hitting on all cylinders and there's a lot of questions going on and things are happening, that's a pretty good sign that you and God are getting some things done, that God is leading you and God is guiding you. Because in what you think is weakness, God is going to take it and He's going to give you perfective strength. That's why Paul said, "Most gladly therefore, well, I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me." And then he said, "Therefore, I take pleasure in my infirmities, in reproaches, in necessities, in persecutions, in distress, for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then am I strong." And today, Pastor just wanted to come tell you, I believe, as men and women of God that are listening to me, I believe you got it right. And I wanted to give you some encouragement in the midst of all the junk you're hearing. I just wanted to tell you that you're getting it right. Square yourself. Lift up your head. Allow God to be the lifter of your head. Allow Him to give you strength. Allow Him to give you wisdom and directions. I know there's a lot of questions flooding the airwaves and everything else that you can imagine. But I want to just encourage you to keep allowing God to be the lifter of your head. Let Him lift you up. Let Him give you the strength that He desires for you to have. Because in the midst of all of this, God's going to supernaturally empower you, and He's going to do the fighting through you. He's going to anoint you. He's going to sustain you. And He is. I see it every day of my life. I see it when men come together to worship Him and women gather together corporately to worship Him. I see it in the community that we're in. I'm having to walk in places and pray for the sick. I'm having to preach funerals. But in the midst of every bit of this, for the child of God, I'm telling you, you're getting it right. So just keep serving God. Keep worshiping Him. Keep obeying Him. Keep doing what He tells you to do. You're going to get through this thing. And on the other side of it, the Scripture says that you and I are going to come out as pure gold. God bless you. I just wanted you to know today that I believe, according to the Word of God, you really are getting it right.